What's going on, everybody? I'm the right Smart Buster.
And I'm the left Smart Buster.
And today, what we're going to do is something that's a reactionary video, because I was just on WWE.com looking at the NXT roster one day, and I was like, because I don't watch the show, but I was like, if anyone who doesn't watch NXT saw this roster, they'd have no idea what anyone's character is, probably because there are no characters. So what we're going to do is I have 157,000 tabs open on Google Chrome. We're just going to go through the entire roster and just laugh at how pitiful they are.
Oh, I'm laughing already. Because this guy's body is shaped like a mannequin that you'd see at a clothing store at a mall.
Aiden English.
This is supposed to be an intimidating wrestler.
Okay, I get his character. He's clearly supposed to be like a Hollywood director, given the dumb outfit and the director's cut finisher. But he's 6'3", 215, so that means he's abnormally skinny.
Oh, but look where he's from.
Uh-oh. I'm from Chicago. Oh, he's a classically trained actor and artist. He's a self-proclaimed man of sophistication, because that gimmick is so original and hasn't been done before ever.
Hey, what's the guy's name? Tit Dow?
Yeah, so I'm not impressed by Aiden English, but he's only the first, so let's move on. Alex Riley!
Oh, wow, everybody's favorite.
Everyone's favorite wrestler is Alex Riley. Look at this smiling goofball.
Can you think of anything more generic than just this guy? he's just a guy.
And look at his attire, just knee pads and elbow pads with no logo or anything.
He's like one of the stock NPCs that, like, they cycle through in a shooter that you kill.
You know what he is? He's original from WrestleMania 2000.
Right, this
you
is just
create your wrestler over this template.
Over this base template. Like, what a loser.
Okay, now this is nice. I like Alexa Bliss. Even though her nose is so huge, you can shove a dime up it. I mean, you know, she's an attractive lady. So we got one winner so far, and one out of three ain't too bad. Let's move on. Angelo Dawkins.
What's his character? He's an atheist.
He's a proven success story when it comes to athletic achievements.
Also, this is one of those black guys that they're going to say is really athletic. Yeah. Possibly the most athletic one on the roster.
And judging by, he used to have a racist gimmick, as you can clearly see here, but they dropped that because he probably sucked at it. And then he used to have a really jobber gimmick with one knee pad. And then now he's got the singlet, so now he's operating under the technical wrestler gimmick.
Oh, he's a great athlete. This has got Orlando Jordan written all over it.
Is anyone interested? His name is Angelo Dawkins. He's just a smiling black goof. We've got enough of that on the roster as it is. Apollo Crews.
Yes, let's take the black guy and name him Apollo.
He looks like Kevin Hart on steroids, and I have no idea what his character is.
He's just like another giant black guy.
Oh, but he's ready to take over.
Okay. You have fun with that, Apollo.
He looks so interesting.
Why don't they just call him Apollo Creed and give him the afro?
Why can't he try to look intimidating? Because they're clearly going for like, oh shit, this guy's for real, and they give him this goofy smile. He looks too much like Kevin Hart to smile, and Kevin Hart fucking sucks.
Oh, wow, Asuka!
She's from Japan!
You racist piece of shit.
Yeah, it's just a continuation of the recent trend amongst divas where they dye their hair a ridiculous color and then do technical wrestling.
This is every beard's wet dream.
Yeah, I'm just gonna move on from this. You know who was better? Fucking Kenzo Suzuki's geisha girl was better than this bitch. Baron Corbin.
Everybody swears this guy's like, he's the next big
Everyone
thing.
Everyone pretends to like this guy. He just looks like a fucking Twilight character. I'm not... Look at, like, even if he is a big guy, look at his face. He has, like, a child's face.
Oh, yeah, I'm Baron.
Oh, Baron.
Baron Corbin. He just looks like that emo kid in your school. Oh, Jesus. Jay Leno. It's Jay Leno.
Hey, guys, it's Jay Leno.
Okay, we're gonna put up a face comparison here. Arizona. Yeah, it's uncanny.
What a boring character.
Speaking of boring, how about Billy Kay? Billy's a guy's name. And what the fuck is with all the Australian
divas? She's 5'8", that's disgusting.
I mean, it's weird, but I wouldn't say disgusting. Look at her face, though. She's like...
I'm tired of all these boring Australians. What's her autistic gimmick?
I don't know.
Swatting bubbles,
too? What kind of sandwich does she serve?
We have Billy Kay sandwich.
Oh, it's Blake.
Oh, it's Blake.
You know, Blake. Let's see how many characters they've tried with him. He had a racist cowboy gimmick. That clearly succeeded. And then here we go. Yeah.
This is just like...
It's Blake.
He looks like Kraven the Hunter.
Is anyone... Oh, here we go. Here's his character. He's got amped up enthusiasm and southern style.
He's the proud resident cowboy of NXT. This is a racist WWE. His cowboys aren't from the south. They're from the west, you morons.
Oh, my God. But you know what, though? Cowboy up, it says on his underwear.
That's great.
Does anyone on the planet think with a name like Blake, this guy's just destined for success? Oh, my God. Okay, now this is a guy I can get behind.
You just tell he's an ass kicker. Everybody makes fun of him.
Because he's fucking ridiculous.
I am a Bull Dempsey, man. Mark.
You know what he is? He's another goofy fat guy character who's just gonna job.
Oh, wow, Bull's making an impact.
We need more of this on the roster, clearly.
I don't know who this is.
I don't care to find out either. Chad Gable.
Oh, wow.
Another guy. He's got the same singlet as Angelo Dawkins. Are they a tag team?
Let me guess. He's got one of those stupid, like, ladies' man gimmicks.
No, I think he's going to be one of those fake technical wrestler gimmicks.
Oh, wow.
But he's 5'8 and 202, so he's completely worthless as far as I'm concerned.
Oh, I can't take these midgets anymore.
I bet he does a lot of kicks.
They're trying to go back to him. They're trying to make him look like Mr. Perfect. Go back.
I have to load up the whole roster again.
Never mind. Fine. But Colin Cassidy.
Yeah, he's from Queens.
Okay, he's big. I guess.
I don't know what his character is.
There's no way he's 276 pounds. They're overestimating.
What's his character? He grew up on the mean streets of Queens.
Okay, this is just...
had to learn to defend himself.
This is just Drew McIntyre. This is literally Drew McIntyre.
Just look at this guy. He's so... Look how boring this guy is. Oh, well, you don't watch the show. Colin's great. No, he's not great. I can tell just by looking at him that he's not great, so fuck you. Corey Graves.
CM Punk.
Yeah, he's just CM Punk. I'm from Pittsburgh, the best city in the world.
I don't even think this guy can wrestle. All I know is he looks like he's a friggin', like, crackhead. Look at that face. Ugh.
Another She-Hulk. This is just what the roster needs. Christ almighty. Why is it so hard to just get attractive women to wrestle? I don't understand. What is it with all the weird Australians and now She-Hulks? I don't understand. Dana Brooke. More like Dana Ass. That was clever. Dash Wilder.
He dies at the end of Shadows of the Empire.
No, he really lived, though. He faked his death so the Rebellion wouldn't send him out on missions anymore. 222 pounds.
Just a velocity jobber. I can hear Tony Chimble saying his name now.
It's
from Asheville, North Carolina. Dash Wilder!
It's Jamie Noble. Let's see. He's had to fight for everything his whole life, and he's got the scars to prove it. Really? Oh, shit. Wow, I'm really invested in his character.
Keep your pants up, Dash. I don't want to see your scars.
What's his character? Moving on. Dasha Fuentes.
Another fake Hispanic, probably.
Look how attractive she is.
That's Caitlyn Jenner. That is Caitlyn Jenner.
Oh, it's Emma.
Ah, wow, Emma Mite Sandwich.
We all know
We've
Emma,
ranted
right?
about her enough.
Yeah, get out of here.
This is just... this is an even gayer version of Kraven the Hunter.
What the fuck? Is this like the anal baby of Draws and Zack Ryder? What the fuck?
Enzo Amore.
Let's see what his... Oh, yeah, Jersey's Finest. So his character is basically Robbie E from TNA. If WWE was missing anything over the years, it was a Jersey Shore Robbie E gimmick. So now they have one, and his name is Enzo Amore, and no one is interested. Yeah, okay.
No one cares about Eva Marie.
Not even Smarks care about Eva Marie. Oh, Jesus Christ.
God, how gay can you get?
Now, I want to...
Oh, he's from Bray.
Special. Very, of course.
Very scary.
My sources tell me that Bray Wyatt, incoming transmission. We have to pay special. I can't talk. We have to pay special attention to how utterly atrocious this fucking guy is. Just by looking at this page. Page, excuse me. 190 pounds. That's right off the bat.
Most fat beards weigh more than this guy.
Well, let's look at this image. This is the champion of the show that everyone is touting is great.
He's wearing leggings.
Who is, like, what is this? And then you go to this picture. Oh, wow, look, he dresses up like a demon.
Looks like Ultimate Carnage.
Yeah, he's got Carnage painted on him. And it's like, okay, well, is his character at all, like, monster related? Well, no. So why does he do this? Because he's a great technical work rate.
Oh, he won the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic.
Like, can someone explain what this... Like, oh, well, he puts all this face paint on. Okay, but if it has nothing to do with his character, then he just comes off as a gay cosplaying neckbeard. Excuse me.
And he has a neckbeard.
And then this one, like... This just straight up looks like a picture in, like, a GQ catalog or something. This is a guy trying to sell you
boxer briefs. The worst part about this guy is that Smarks will just rant online about how I'd go gay for Balor.
He looks gay. Like, what is this? This is the fucking future of wrestling? Look at this guy. Oh, Fergal. And this stupid move, the Coupe de Grace, it's a double stomp. Because he can't do anything because he weighs 190 pounds. Moving on.
Greg Hamilton. Okay. The worst part is that that's probably not his real name. Like, that's what they came up with.
Yeah, no, he's just the broadcaster, so we'll give him a break. He can't be any worse than any of the broadcasters they have now.
He looks like an evening news anchor with that jaw.
He looks like Greg Amsinger.
He looks like Chet You Betcha.
This guy's probably shorter than Chet You Betcha. Ooh,
Kenta!
Look at his gay emo hair, and this guy doesn't wear socks. We've ranted on this douchebag enough, but we have to reiterate that. Look at his finisher. It's a kick. And because all the rest of his moves are kicks, you can guarantee that every match this guy's in is going to be just intolerable.
I don't like him.
Oh, but you don't watch the show! Yeah, this is why I don't watch the show, because look at this guy.
He's like an angry PMSing Tajiri.
Didn't we see this guy already?
No, you were thinking of Chad something.
Oh, no, Angelo Dawkins.
Wait, this guy's black?
This guy is definitely black, I think. Okay, well, let's start from the beginning here, because this guy's gone through four different gimmicks.
Oh, God.
Here we have fucking... who does he look like here? JTG with the fucking mini afro. And then here he kind of...
Now he's just smiling.
I don't know what they're going for here. And then here he looks like Randy Orton, but like black. His finishing move is the Jordan Slam.
Oh, wow. And he's from Chicago.
That's like if you have... It's like if Steve Austin's finisher was the Steve Slam.
This is probably another one of those guys that they hype as like a real athlete.
And then he's just so fucking boring.
He's a great colleague athlete.
I bet this guy can't cut a promo to save his life.
I am Jason Jordan.
He looks like EC3, but like black. And maybe with even less charisma. Alright, that may be going too far. Let's see if this gives us any indication of what his character is. Proven time and time again to be a successful athlete.
There you go. Like that. This is just the guy that Michael Cole is going to spew oral jizz about how amazing of an athlete he is.
Of course, what a throw. What do we got here? JoJo. We know JoJo already. She does interviews and she's like 2 years old. So if you lust after her, you're a pedophile, just like Jerry.
Marcus Lewis. This is just like...
It's Marcus Lewis.
This is just Snitsky.
No, but he wasn't always Snitsky.
Oh, wait. So he went from like a really gay-looking Charlie Haas to Snitsky.
This guy is a fucking... He's destined for complete failure. Hey, like, how do you go from this one day? Like, hi, I'm Jobber Man, to this, hi, I'm Character Jobber Man. Because you know what? This guy, even if he is doing anything in NXT right now, he's going to come up, and JBL's going to go, this guy can't beat anyone, Maggle!
He sucks, Maggle! What's he doing with his mouth, Maggle? What's that?
He's an outrageous Frenchman with a perfect example of what the French lifestyle is all about. Oh, that's what it's all about. French lifestyle is about having
fun. That's not what I get from looking at him. He looks like they're trying to make him out to be like a Snitsky.
Yeah, it's all about having fun there, John.
Cheese.
Mojo Rawley.
Apparently everybody hates this guy.
290. He's probably actually the only one who's good. Oh, wait, take that back. Look at this picture. He looks like fucking Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle. What the fuck is this? Can someone tell me what these people's characters are? He's got passion and perseverance and pride. Okay, so far, every biography we've seen has been either how people had to claw and fight or how they're great athletes. Nothing about what their character is. Can someone help? No one watches wrestling to go, oh, well, this guy's a good athlete and this guy perseveres. You watch to see characters.
He was bullied when he was little and went to Banana Splits, but now he's a big boy.
Murphy.
Really getting original there with those names there, Taz.
Oh, Murphy's Law. This guy doesn't make laws. He's the one that gets arrested.
They got a guy on their show whose ring name is Blake, and now Murphy.
He doesn't look scary at all.
He looks like Dolph Ziggler with orange hair instead of spaghetti jizz hair. Like, look, it's just Dolph Ziggler. Ah, this is Dolph Ziggler. Look at him. But he's adaptable. That's his character there, John. He's adaptable.
What does that mean?
I don't know. It means that he's up for anal or oral. Oh, look, it's Nia Jax.
What on earth is this monstrosity?
Her build weight is 200 pounds.
That is gross. Ah, Hannah!
Oh, but you know
look
what?
Look at the attitude with her. Wait, is she white?
She's probably, like, Hispanic or something. I don't know. But all I know is that she's not like most divas.
Oh, I mean, she's unique and interesting.
She's the weight of two of them. Look at her. Jesus. Like, why? They're doing this just to annoy me, I think. There's no reason for this. They're like, oh, look at us. We got a disgusting fat slob. We love social justice. Yeah, okay.
Peyton is a boy's name.
This doesn't, like...
This another just, Aussie.
This just looks like some girl from somewhere. Like, there's nothing special about it. And look how weird her face is. She's making the Renee Young noise in this picture.
Canada. Kangaroos, eh?
Oh, but she has graceful moves, though.
Oh, wow.
Might confuse her for a dancer. Is that her gimmick? Give her a dancing gimmick. She's white. Oh, yeah, here's a wrestler.
Why is he in... Is he really in NXT?
I don't know. I don't watch NXT. But, like, this is the shit we're talking about here. This is what no one else has on this whole thing. This is Rhino. Everybody fucking likes this guy.
He's a former hardcore champion.
You know, he's never really main evented anything in his whole fucking life. But people just got behind him because he had, like, an aura and a mystique about him.
And he was an absolute animal.
Where is the aura and mystique behind Enzo Amore or Aiden English or Blake? Whatever. It's Rich Brennan.
Hey, guys, I'm Rich Brennan.
Fuck you, Rick Berman. Ugh.
Of course, we don't need to rant on this little...
Look at his picture. He's dancing in the picture. Hell of a kick. So him and Kenta should form a tag team just called the Kickers. They can come out to the Paul Revere and the Raiders song, Kicks. Oh, look, it's Samoa Joe. Wow.
Samoa Joe!
Why couldn't we get Scott Steiner?
You know why I like Samoa Joe, though? Because he ended Tyson Kidd's career.
Okay, then. Samoa Joe. Yeah.
He's another guy with no fucking character. I'm surprised he isn't an NXT original. Because he look like with a ring name like Samoa Joe. Although knowing NXT, from what I've seen from looking at the roster page, they would just call him Joe with no Samoa.
Yeah, right.
Oh, it's Joe in a triple threat match with Blake and Murphy. Winner gets a last name.
Sawyer.
Are they fucking kidding with this shit? Another black guy. Is he black?
Is this another great athlete?
It's just another guy.
Let me guess. This guy's also a great athlete.
He comes from a small farm.
Yes, I see.
He worked hard all his life.
I see the words NCAA.
All-American. He's another All-American who persevered.
A great athlete.
And of course, let's see how many gimmicks he went through. He had like a weird Hitler Muslim gimmick, obviously. Then he had like a weird I'm trying to have character gimmick.
Looks like Jack Swagger.
And now he's having the I'm an athlete gimmick.
Oh my God.
Sawyer Fulton. That's the best they can come up with.
Why don't they just call this guy Huckleberry Finn and get it over with? I would have more respect for them if they just called him Huck Finn. Here's another one. Scott Dawson.
Scott Dawson. 224.
It sounds like the name of like a laundry bleach.
Look at this guy. What is this? Okay, is his character that he's a redneck? Is that his character? He's from North Carolina, so is that it? He's a redneck? Oh, no, he's been a survivor his whole life. He's persevered like everyone else on this fucking roster. I can't believe what I'm looking at and reading. Simon Gotch?
Oh, his name is Gotch!
Is he related to Frank Gotch? Oh, the Gentleman's Clutch. He's just another one with the intellectual savior of the masses gimmick.
Why is he wearing that, like, bondage gear?
I don't know. He's the most unique NXT superstar.
Oh, very unique.
Of course, his
character is very spooky, very quirky. Follow him on Twitter.
Okay, he's a vaudevillain, I guess, judging by the advertisements. Okay, so he does vaudeville shows? What does he do? He throws pies at people's face or something, and he sings and dances?
This is just Charlie Chapman.
Charlie... Charlie Chaplin. Not Chapman.
I'm sorry. I always skipped that chapter in my textbook.
I mean, like, how many of these gimmicks are we going to have where, oh, yes, I'm the refined gentleman and you're the peasant and I'm going to beat you?
The gentleman's clutch sounds like a sex position.
Yeah. It's a gay sex position where he just gently clutches your cock. Oh, it's Solomon Crow. If you thought Baron Corbin was a gay emo, look at this
what
guy.
What on earth am I looking at?
He's from Anonymous, Ohio. And he weighs 207 pounds, so he's completely worthless.
He looks like there's like a dead roadkill skunk on his head.
Oh, but you know what? He's a modern-day Robin Hood. He takes advantage of the elite. Oh, okay, so he's like...
Well, I hope Little John sits on you.
Yeah. He probably wants that. He's like, hey, Little John, sit on my face. Look at this. Like, who's gonna get... He looks like a fat guy just farted in his face and blew his hair back.
Solomon and Little John walking through the forest.
All right, with that, I'm gonna move on because this guy's boring.
Okay, his name is Sylvester.
He looks like Sylvester Turkai, but like they just sucked all the weight out of him.
He looks like Ringo.
They sucked 200 pounds out of him. He's 190 pounds.
This is Ringo Starr. Look at that. That's Ringo.
Another guy from France. Does he show us what the French lifestyle's about too there, John?
Oh, wow. The French tickler.
Let's see. He's an eccentric Frenchman there, John.
Did he struggle and persevere, or perhaps he was a great athlete?
Or perhaps both there, yeah. I just spat all over the monitor. Hold nice. On. Hello.
Hi, great body shop, Tom.
I'm a generic American man.
Wait, who the hell is this? Oh, it's Tom Phillips. Okay.
Why did they get this guy?
Who's Ty Dillinger?
I don't know what this means. Oh, I got it. Is his character that he's like a judge or something?
Or he's like, got a big dick?
Yeah, 10 inches. Like, I don't understand. And here he's just a jobber like everyone else on this roster. He's slick, smooth, and oozing with confidence. Ooh, man. Let's see. Is he a great athlete?
He looks like a heroin addict.
Okay, so this guy's not a great athlete, nor did he persevere. He's just oozing with confidence. And he's bragging about having a 10-inch dick.
He's great on the mic.
A 10-inch dick is worthless if you're shoving it up men's asses, though. Speaking of shoving it up men's asses...
It's Mr. Clean himself, Tyler Breeze.
I don't think we really need to continue. He's got sperm oozing out of his boots. So
he's making the duck face.
Yeah. And, of course, supermodel kick is his finisher. This is the third guy, which is the kick is their finisher. Moving on.
Wow!
Yes, that's very beautiful dropkick. Why does he have this fucking stupid hairdo nowadays? Look how gay he looks. Hello, I'm William Regal. I never really minded William Regal, but now the fact that he's in NXT, he looks like he's wearing fucking lipstick. The coral blue number something, even though it's purple. And finally, because, you know...
Broski.
This is NXT. This is why we don't watch NXT. This roster is filled with losers.
Lame.
Blake.
Murphy.
Fucking, I already forgot.
I don't even remember them.
An endless supply of black guys in singlets with just names as their ring names.
Who are great athletes.
Of course. I know, everyone had to persevere, and they're from France there, John.
Look, it's Matthew Hogg.
Oh, he... See, does anyone know why I'm getting Facebook notifications when I'm not on Facebook anymore?
That's really creepy.
They just pop up everywhere now. Someone help me. Someone send me an email and tell me why this is happening. I can't escape from Facebook. And it's only the Chrome Facebook. It's not my Firefox Facebook.
Oh, then that means there's probably an extension running. I could fix that.
Oh, all right. Whatever.
Fuck Cody Rhodes.
Yeah, and NXT.